Hello to you once again, and welcome back to Rio, to the Olympic Shooting Centre. This is the very finals hall that held the illustrious Rio Olympic Games just under 8 years ago now, back in 2016, and it's still looking as great as it did back then for the Olympic Games. Of course, we're in another Olympic year, and this is the ISSF final Olympic qualification championship for rifle and pistol. So this is it, the last chance saloon. Medals, of course, are at stake, and those invaluable, priceless quota places. Now, here's a list of some of the qualified athletes already. So in this particular final, all eight athletes are eligible for the quota place. There's a few names in there that you'd recognise. Lights of Ewong Ho, Damir Miketz, Jason Solari. And there you can see the open slots, 25 and 26, for this competition right here, the Olympic qualification. The final chance here in Rio de Janeiro. This competition runs through to next Friday. And we've had two quota places awarded in the last final. That's for the 10-metre air pistol women. And now we'll have two more quota places awarded for this men's final. So the bullseye is only 11.5 millimetres over a distance of 10 metres, 24 shots, unless, of course, we do go to a shoot-off. And that will happen at any stage where we're running through the eliminations and there is a tie. And all eight athletes now just preparing to shoot in this final. One left-handed athlete on firing point F. That's Kim Chung-yong of the People's Republic of Korea. Otherwise, the rest are all right-handers. So we've got just under 90 seconds to go. You can see the backs of the coaches sitting down the front. The ever-present Claudia Klaus from Germany is there, looking on to Philipp Grimm of Germany, who's now 31 years old. And he's the third eldest competitor in this final. We have Yi Tam-yong at 35 and Yusuf Diketz of Turkey, who already took a gold medal a few days ago in the mixed team pistol. That was on day one on Friday. So he'll bring that medal form and confidence into this 10-metre air pistol men's final, which is due to start at 11 a.m. local time in Rio de Janeiro, which translates as January River. But the actual river January is actually a bay, just to confuse you. So that's the Chief Range Officer, Oscar Martinez of Venezuela, just calling the 30-second command. That just makes sure the athletes know that they're into the final stages of the preparations before we get underway with this final. So two athletes from the Republic of Korea. Only one is eligible for a quota place should they finish this final near the top. There's 51-year-old Yusuf Diketz, just with the visor, no blinder, just with glasses, both eyes. It's incredible how he shoots like that. I just wouldn't be able to do it. So Jamie Stangroom of Great Britain is making the announcements. So Yi Tam-yong waves and bows to the crowd. Such experience at 35 years old. So Valeri Rakhimshan of Kazakhstan, 25 years old, takes a wave. So Yufit Diketz, just look at those medals right the way across his career. Already a gold medalist 2 days ago. Will it be another medal today? Here's Philipp Grimm, 34 years old, of Germany. And a big cheer from the German supporters. So Victor Banking, 33 years old, takes a bow and looks very focused. So Kim Jong-yong, so respectful with the bow. Just look at those gold medals. Will it be another gold today? So Vladislav Demish, an individual neutral athlete in this competition. What's in store for him today? So Federico Nilo Maldini, 23 years old, big cheer from the Italian crowd. So Israel Blanco of Guatemala getting his introduction as the jury in charge. As we just take a look there at Mauro Barricci, who's the Italian coach, clapping along. And once again, the chief range officer will be Oscar Martinez of Venezuela. So there is Israel Blanco, just setting his stopwatch, and there's Oscar Martinez. I'm a big fan of those microphones, the Shure SM58. You can't beat it. So that's how it finished in qualification. Philipp Grimm of Germany, top score of 585. Just one in front of three other athletes. And here's how they line up from firing point A right down to H. So two athletes from the Republic of Korea. Only one can take a quota place, but all eight athletes eligible for two quota places in this final, but only one, as I said, can go to Korea. So the start command has been given. We are underway. If you are just joining us, just informing you of the world record, 246.5 set by Kim Song-guk of North Korea. Will the world record go today? Well, it has stood since 2019, almost 5 years. So 10.9 is the highest individual score. And already a 10.8 from the German Philipp Grimm. Great way to start this first five-shot series. Once the first five-shot series is completed, we'll then move to a second series of five shots and then move to individual shots, and the eliminations will start from shot 12, and then the eliminations will go through to shot 22, where the bronze medal is then decided, and then silver and gold is decided over shot 24. Breath control, so important. Stability, steadiness. Placing your feet in the right position. And then it just comes down to your own individual style. You'll see, I always do love watching Youssef Dikec, just because he just looks so natural, just so relaxed, like he's just looking down the road, waiting for a bus. But yeah, he's so experienced at 51 years old. As we look now at Maldini of Italy, I would guess that he works out quite a bit, wouldn't you? So who will take the early advantage in this final? Still a couple of athletes with three shots to go. That's Maldini and Grimm. Meanwhile, Dimesh has raced off. Last shot was a 10.8. As an individual neutral athlete in this final. Currently on 41.1. Now, a score above 52 at the end of the five-shot series, you'd expect to be up there with the leaders. Certainly anywhere near 53. And that's real top world-class shooting, particularly in a pistol final. So Yi Damyok of Republic of Korea, first to finish on a total of 51.0. Bankin of Ukraine, 9.9, so his total's 48.7. And Dimesh finishes his five-shot series with a shot in the 10 ring, just, but it's there, 10.0. And it's always good to carry a score into the 10s into your next five-shot series. Kim, Republic of Korea, with a 10.5. Grimm of Germany is now completed. It's just Maldini of Italy to finish this five-shot series. 30 seconds left on the clock. So Federico is going to have to be as quick as the illustrious Paolo Maldini, who was such a legend in the world of football. So quick as well. Maldini really has to get on with it. And does so. 9 seconds remaining and puts in a 9.3. I think he's just checking his pistol. He's clearly not happy with that last shot. And just blowing some air down. And Dimesh, who's an individual neutral athlete, leads this competition. 51.1. It's just the narrowest of gaps. A 0.1 gap between Dimesh and Grimm. And then we've got two athletes tied for second. Both Grimm and Yi of Republic of Korea. And then some very narrow margins as we move into the next five-shot series.
For the next competition series, no.
Such a commanding voice, hasn't he, Oscar Martinez? You certainly know he's in the room, even without a microphone. So experienced in the world of shooting. It's great to have someone of his caliber as the chief range officer here in the finals hall at the Olympic Shooting Center in Rio. Great shot from Bankin, 10.6. Great way to start the second series of five shots to get a real score in the mid-10s into the higher section of the 10 ring, considering that bullseye is only 11.5 millimetres. He's so still, is Grimm. Such a great technique. Breath control, controlling the heart rate, doing everything he's done in qualification and in training, and then bringing it here to the finals hall, and that's what makes it count. So just looking at Dimesh now. Last shot was a 10.6. Maldini with another shot in the 9 ring, a 9.9. Just making an adjustment to his pistol. He's clearly not happy with something. So 35-year-old Lee Tae-myung, bringing his experience of a gold medal, even at a World Cup, way back in London 2012, in the competition before the Olympics. Just shows you how long he's been around, taking gold. Shake of the head there, and again, you've got to be disappointed with an 8.8 shot. He probably can't afford any more than that, because he's in 8th place at the moment. Sorry, 5th place at the moment with an 8.8. So if he's to keep in touch with the top 4, he needs to get those shots up into the 10 ring. It's Kim of Republic of Korea currently in 8th place. Meanwhile, this time Maldini has got a shift on, and he's raced off and completed that five-shot series. And Dimesh finishes this time with a 10.0. And really a score anywhere around 101. And Dimesh is just 0.1 off that score, you would certainly have to say is world class. So that completes the two series of five shots. This is where it gets interesting now. We move into individual shots. And Dimesh led earlier with a difference of 0.1. That was in front of Grimm of Germany. Grimm now down to fourth place. It's Maldini of Italy who moves up to second. 1.5 behind. That's the gap between first and second. Meanwhile, just keep an eye on Kim of Republic of Korea, down in eighth place, 1.3 behind, which is certainly a difference you can make up in pistol shooting over two shots. So this will be shot 11, and then shot 12 will be our first elimination shot in this final. So if you have just joined us, welcome. Thanks for coming along to see this final on ISSF TV at the final Olympic Qualification Championship for rifle pistol in this Olympic year. And if you're watching on YouTube, do subscribe to the channel. That way you'll get a notification of all of our broadcasts, not just the finals, but also all of the content that we bring to you, including our current series of Road to Paris, which, if you've been watching those episodes, I'm sure you've been enjoying over the last few weeks. So Grimm once again with a high shot, 10.6. He had one of those earlier in this final, and he's going to need more of those as he's moved back into second place. And the German is not going to give up. Dimesh, meanwhile, an individual neutral athlete at the top of the competition in terms of his score, 110.6. And Kim has managed to close the gap in 8th place to 0.9. And this shot will now decide his fate in this final. Will Kim survive? We've got to look also at the gap between Bankin of Ukraine and Diketch of Turkey, because that's a 2.5 gap between 7th and 6th. Tense moments as we go into the first elimination. And an 8.8 from Kim. Puts his safety flag into his pistol. It's going to be all over for him. So Kim Jong-yong takes a bow. A gallant effort, but not quite enough on the day. Leaves the competition in 8th place with a total of 114.0. So Dimash at the top, a 1.5 gap was how it stood a few seconds ago. He's still at the top. This time the gap is the smallest it can be, a 0.1 difference between Dimash and Grimm. The German will not give up. Meanwhile, keep an eye on Maldini as well. He's managed to recover over the last few shots and finds himself in 3rd place. 2 quota places are available for the remaining 7 athletes. Also, there's the medals. There's gold, silver and bronze. You can't forget about that too. So now we've said goodbye to one athlete from the Republic of Korea. It does mean now that if Lee Dae-myung was to finish high enough, he will claim a quota place for the Republic of Korea. And some shots in the nines. Starting to feel the pressure of this final. Meanwhile, Grimm of Germany, the only one in the 10 ring. That's a 10.1, and that's solid. So Grimm of Germany takes the lead with a difference of 0.2. That's a great stage of the final, just as you're coming into the elimination phases. And Grimm's been there or thereabouts, and now will want to keep up that consistency, and that'll do his confidence the world of good. So this will decide 7th. So load, says Oscar Martinez. So Bankin of Ukraine, with his cheek and chin tucked right into his shoulder. You can see there, Rakhimzan, much more of a different style, but it's just whatever works for you. Difference of 0.4, 10.3 and a 10.3 for both athletes. So a 0.6 gap means 7th place is now decided. And Victor Bankin just inserts the safety flag into his pistol and gives a wave to the crowd. That's always nice to see. Very respectful. And leaves this final in 7th place. Wipes the sweat from his brow and takes a seat next to Vladimir Ivanchuk. So is there a change at the top? Well, Philipp Grimm was 0.1 behind. He's now 0.2 in front. And the German leads the way for the first time in this competition with a clear lead over Dimash, who's an individual neutral athlete. Maldini, meanwhile, for Italy, still in 3rd place. And Youssef Diketz, who was already a gold medalist, as we look at him now, preparing to take his next shot, took gold on day one a few days ago here in this very finals hall in the mixed team competition. So can Diketz survive? Such a natural shooting style, just nothing fancy, no blinders, both eyes, one pistol, one trigger. What will he score? He's 0.8 behind at the moment in 6th place. Oh, 10.4. Meanwhile, Rakhimzan with a 9.8. So there's a 0.6 difference. Oh, it means Diketz 0.1 behind. What an interesting stage of this final. And Diketch, great shot, 10.4. It just shows you how the gaps can close. There's a 0.1 gap between 6th and 5th. Another 0.1 gap between 5th and 4th. And this next shot is to decide 6th. This is shot 16.
Next competition shot. No.
So Youssef Diketz, with the gold medal 2 days ago, is now up against Lee Tam-hyung of Republic of Korea. And a 10.3 from the Korean. He's going to need a 10.4 or higher to stay in. Oh, and it's a 9.5. A painful moment for Youssef Diketz. Inserts his safety flag into his pistol. And it was a gold medal 2 days ago, and it's not to be a medal or a quota place today for the 51-year-old from Turkey 8. And removes his visor, ruffles his hair, and goes to take his seat to watch the rest of this final. Painful moment for the 51-year-old, but that's how shooting works sometimes, and that's how it rolls. So down to the final five. Some of those differences, so narrow. 0.2 difference between 5th and 4th. 0.3 difference between 4th and 3rd. And Maldini of Italy has crept up into 2nd place and is 1.4 behind not only the fellow country of Germany and Italy right next to each other, but Philipp Grimm of Germany at the top. And it's certainly not looking grim at all. It's looking great for the German. So Valeri Rakhimzhan of Kazakhstan, with that leaning back approach, it seems to work for him. And a 9.7, can't believe it, has a word with himself as well, is disappointed, looks over and down to the screen and just wonders whether or not this final is slipping away for him. He's now 0.8 behind Maldini of Italy, who's tied for 3rd place. And it's been an interesting final for Maldini, because there's been those shots in the 9 ring. There's a few there in the 10s that brought him up and to 2nd place. And you just have to wonder whether or not the Italian can hang on, not only for a medal, but perhaps even a quota place. So Grimm of Germany still leads. The gap is now 1.7. And it's Lee Tam-hyung, closest to our screens in the red t-shirt, who's now in 2nd place. Tense moments now in this final. 2 quota places available for the Paris Olympic Games. Maldini again tinkering with his pistol. A 10.7 from the Italian, a great shot. But it does mean 5th place is now decided, and Rakhimzhan of Kazakhstan will leave this final. A total of 176.0. And a decent performance. At least he has a smile. That's always nice to see. As Roland Yumasetnetov just congratulates him. So Philipp Grimm of Germany, will this final slip away, or will he stay in the gold medal position? He's 0.6 in front at the moment of Lee Tam-hyung, and only a 0.2 get difference between 3rd and 2nd. Maldini, the Italian, still in there, and Dimesh, who led this competition in the early stages in both the 1st and 2nd 5-shot series, who's an individual neutral athlete. Here he is, shooting to stay in this final. Currently on 177.9. And shots 14 and 15 are what's perhaps been the cause for him to slip down to fourth place. He's still only 21 years old and scores a 9.8. Great shot from Grimm, a 10.2, the only shot of the four to come into the 10 ring, and the Germans up at the back there go crazy. So we've got a tie for second. Maldini of Italy and Dimesh both on 187.7. Meanwhile, just bear in mind that Yi Tamyong is only 0.4 behind. So here comes shot number 20. And the start command is given, 50 seconds once again on the clock. And 50 seconds to decide the future of Yi Tamyong, the 35-year-old from Republic of Korea. Can he stay in this final? Stay in the hunt for a medal? They're still at stake. And those two quota places, priceless for the Paris Olympic Games. Shake of the head from Grimm, it's an 8.1. And Maldini takes the lead, but meanwhile, fourth place has been decided. And Yi Tamyong takes a seat and finishes on 195.7, not enough to stay in this final. And there's a 0.4 gap between third and second. Maldini of Italy, for the first time, we did mention earlier on, just to keep on going in a final like this. Now Maldini has just kept plugging away and now leads the competition representing Italy. So this is shot 21. We're down to the final three. If you are just joining us on ISSF TV, welcome. You've arrived just at the right time because we're moving into the medal stages and also to decide two quota places for any one of these three athletes. Such pressure when there's medals and quota places on the line. And two shots of a 10.0, 9.3 from Grimm. So the occasion just getting to him a little bit. Was leading the competition, now down to third place. He's still only 0.3 behind Dimesh, who's an individual neutral athlete. Maldini of Italy, meanwhile, I wonder what's going through his mind right now, because he's 1.1 in front and starting to put a gap between first and second. It's a terrific performance from the Italian. Federico Nilo Maldini is still only 23 years old. So here we go to decide the bronze medal, which will also effectively decide the quota places for the gold and silver medalists. ...10.3 from Dimesh, and Grimm with a 9.0. So it's all gone wrong for the German. Maldini hit an 8.4 meanwhile. So Philipp Grimm takes the first medal of this men's 10-metre air pistol final. And the 31-year-old is congratulated by Claudia Kraus, the German coach. And Germany have their first medal here in Rio at this ISSF Olympic Qualification Championship for rifle and pistol. So the quota places are confirmed. There's the logo of the Olympics, right next to the names of Dimesh and Maldini. There's a 0.8 gap between these two athletes. It's now down to the gold medal decision over the next two shots. Will it be Italy? Will it be Dimesh, who's an individual neutral athlete? What a final this is shaped up to be. So here we go. The excitement, the drama is now about to be concluded. Breath control, controlling the heart rate to 10.5 from Maldini. That's a great shot for the Italian. And a 9.4, so it's switched around once again. Maldini of Italy, the 23-year-old, now leads the competition. And he's got a gap of 0.3 between him and Dimesh. Can the Italian now hang on for the gold medal? He knows that the quota place is already in the bag. Just focusing now on his breathing as he goes to take the final shot. Meanwhile, Dimesh, who led the competition for some time, can he switch this around once again? It would be the third time that these two have switched round. Will Dimesh take gold or will it be silver? Maldini with a 9.9, a 9.3 from Dimesh, and a punch of the air from the Italian. And most of the Italian supporters on their feet to applaud. Some with their phones out, just feeling it. And just feeling the emotion and capturing it all on their mobile phones. And Federico Nilo Maldini, 23 years old, representing Italy, is the gold medalist here in this 10-metre air pistol men's final. Oh, bellissimo, I think the Italians will be saying at this stage. Vladislav Dimesh stands next to Maldini, to his right, taking the silver medal. So Philipp Grimm of Germany, hand aloft, is the bronze medalist representing Germany. So Vladislav Dimesh, an individual neutral athlete in this final, gets the silver medal and a quota place for the Paris Olympic Games. Well, you have to say that's one of the best performances I've seen in a 10-metre air pistol final for a long time. Talk about grit and determination. Right there, the Italian has done just that. And much to the applause of the Italian crowd as well, who are on their feet to applaud this performance from the 23-year-old Federico Nilo Maldini. What a final that was. Thanks very much for joining us on ISSF TV. Don't go anywhere though, we'll be back later this evening, 6 p.m. 6 o'clock local time in Rio for the 10-metre air rifle mixed team. We'll see you later.
Federico, congratulations. You won the gold medal here in Rio, which means you've secured a quota place for the Paris Olympic Games. How do you feel?
I can't describe what I feel now. So I'm very, very happy. I can't describe it. So it's unbelievable for me. It's my target this, and I'm very, very, very proud of me to be here.
You should be proud. Would you say this is the proudest moment of your career so far?
Yeah. For now, yes. It's the best moment of my career, yeah. Of course.
And the interesting thing is you actually secured the quota place like 3 or 4 shots before the final finished. Did that enter your mind? Did you know you had already secured the quota place?
No. I don't know what I...
What happened in my head, in my brain, so I don't know.
You were very good. It's not personal. It's a technical thing.
I know. Questa è peggio. Per un'altra finale vorrei fare.
So I will ask in English, and you want to then translate,
okay.
And you can answer in Russian, and you can, but I will hold the microphone, don't worry about the microphone, okay?
That is the very competitive final, but made it to the good quality place for the Paris Olympic Games. How do you feel?
Unbelievable. I'm really я очень часто получал рецензии, это было
невероятно.
Я хочу передать большую благодарность моим родителям.
Don't worry, it's an important moment. Congratulations and enjoy the podium now, okay?
Thank you.
I'm proud of myself.
I'm proud that I'm
staying in Rio
and
I want to wish luck for me and other athletes in the Olympic Games in Paris.
Great messages. Thank you very much, Vladislav. Enjoy the podium.
Is the medal ceremony for the 10-metre air pistol men's event. The medals will be presented by Mr. Carlos Silva Monterosso, President of the American Shooting Confederation. He will be accompanied by Mr. Jefferson Edmonton, President of the Brazilian Shooting Confederation. Bronze medal representing Germany goes to Philipp Grimm. Silver medal representing individual and neutral athletes with a Paris 2024 quota place, Vladislav Vorobyev. Gold medal with a Paris 2024 quota place representing Italy, Federico Nicolo Maldini. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Italy. Thank you. autographs to be taken of our medalists. Now ask the medal presenters to join them. Congratulations once again to Philip Grimm, Radislav Demish, and Federico Nino Maldini. Thank you.